So in last class, we have learned some of the tools, right? Only the sketching tools. In today's class, we'll complete the remaining modifying tools, as well as I'll just explain you what is the how to make a sketch constraint that is geometrically as well as dimensionally constrained. Okay. Hello.
Yes, sir. I'm not able
to... Yeah, yeah, you are. You are.
Sir, actually, I have some doubts that need to increase clarity.
No, your voice is a bit low.
Sir, I have some doubts, sir.
Yeah, ask me.
While opening my, sir, can I share my screen?
Yes, I'll just. Okay. Am I audible clearly? No issues with my sound, right?
No, sir.
So, okay. So yesterday we have completed this whole profiles. Now today I'll just complete this operations. Then we'll just move on to the types of constraint and how to make a sketch constraint. Later on, I'll just give you an example of a sketch. Okay. So the first thing is called as corner. So corner is nothing but it will just remove the sharp ends. Okay. See here. So where it is, see here it is the shortcut. Just press shift. It will be horizontal. So here it is corner. Just select this one and this one. Now you can notice the arc is being created. Once you click it, a corner thing will be created. And if you want to vary the radius, you can vary the radius. Okay. At the same time, we have chamfer. Just select these two lines from where you want to chamfer. Just click it there. Here you can assign the angle, whatever you want, as well as the length of the chamfer, what you want. Any doubts in radius and chamfer, fillet and chamfer?
No, sir.
Okay. So next we have a thing called re-elimination tools. Here we have a thing called trim. So don't use this trim. Instead of, we'll directly go with this quick trim. Why? I'll explain you. See here. So as of now, the trim what we have used, if I try to select, if I select trim command and if I select this one, so we know the inner thing should be deleted, right? If I do trimming now. So but what happens in this trim means, so it will start trimming from that particular point. So it is quite difficult to handle this kind of trim. So it is working as a trim as well as it is working as a full-time, what we say, extend command. So that's why what we'll do is we'll go with this quick trim. So just double click. So just click on this. So it will be trimming. Okay. So whatever all the things you don't need, you just select that. It will be trimming it out. Okay. Got it. So next, what we have, it is called as close arc. So this thing, so it will just complete the arcs. For example, say, if I have an arc like this and if I want it to be a full circle, just select this, just click on this, it will complete that arc. Okay. So same way we have a thing called complete here. So complement, sorry. So once you select this, so it will just prepare the remaining half of the arc. Okay. Instead of making it a full circle, it will give you the remaining part of that particular arc. So next I just skip this point. So this is called as break. So now you can see this is a single entity line, right? It's a full entity. So if you want to break it, so I'll go with this break command here. So I'll just select this line. I want to select this line and just give a point where you want to break it. So I've given a point here. So now you can notice there are two lines now. Okay. Any issues? Any doubts?
No, sir.
Okay. So the next thing is called as mirror. So mirror is a command. For example, see if I have drawn something here, I want it to be at the same distance for upon this line. So just select this mirror, select the entity and select that mirroring line. It will be mirrored exactly. And the thing is, if you vary something here, so both the variations will be taken. Okay. So just because it's a mirror copy of it. Okay. So if you have multiple entities, for example, say I have this much of circles. So what you can do is just press and hold the control button and select all these entities. So once it is selected, leave the control button, select the mirror command and just select this mirroring line. It will be mirrored. Okay. So the next thing is called as symmetric. So what it will do is it will just, if you select this and deselect, it will be replaced from that instead of being mirrored. So it will be replaced upon that. And the distance from here to here and from here to here will always be same. Okay. So next we have a thing called translate, which is rarely used. So translate, it is used to move that particular entity. Instead of using this translate, what we can do is I'll just click and hold this and I can move wherever I want. Okay. Same way, if you want to rotate it, you can rotate it wherever you want to, and you can assign the angles later on. So next thing, it is called as scaling. If you want to scale this, for example, I'll assign the dimensions to it. Now I'll assign the dimension to it as 50. So now what I'll do is I'll just click on the scale. I'll just switch off this duplicate mode, select this and select this as your point. So now I'll increase the ratio to 2. So now you can notice it was before 50. Now it has become doubled. Okay. So again, instead of doing that, what you can do is you can just double click on that particular diameters or radius. You can change it, whatever the dimensions you want. Got my point? Any issues?
No, sir. Got
your
point.
Okay.
No, sir.
Okay. So the next thing is called as offset. So offset is nothing but it will assign the distance from, I'll select this and I'll select this line. So it will carry the same properties, whatever all the things you have given to that particular line, and it will be moved to some distance, and that distance can be easily maintained by you by changing this dimension here. Okay. So this much we have in our, transformation tool. So this is nothing but the operations is complete, and the remaining this part, it is totally used for 3D geometries. Okay. I'll explain you at the time of 3D modeling. It is not necessary now for the 2D sketches. So once we'll enter to this 3D models, I'll explain you. Okay. So now the major important thing is making a sketch constraint. So what is the meaning of constraint? Anyone? What is the meaning of constraint? Reddy, what is the meaning of constraint?
Sorry, limitation or some restrictions.
Limitations or some restrictions, right?
Yes.
Lekhana and Divya, do you agree with them?
Sir.
Okay. So it's a good answer. So constraint is nothing but it's a limitations or any restrictions to be given. For example, say I have created a sketch here, and if I come out of it and I'll just add up the material to this guy. So now the part has been created without any issues, right? See, the circular rod has been created, but the problem arises when you try to assemble these things. So at the time of assembly, if it is not restricted or it is not fixed to a point. So what happens means at the time of assemblies, it will try to move. Okay. So as it is the sketch of this, so that is nothing but the base of this thing is not fixed at a point. So at the time of assemblies, it will try to manipulate itself. It will try to move itself, or it will try to it will try to not take the orders what you are going to give. So that is nothing but the constraints what you are going to apply. So that's why making a sketch constraint is mandatory. So that sketch constraints are all of two types. Okay. So one is called as geometrical constraints. So another one is called as dimensional constraints. So do you know any type of geometrical constraints? Lekhana, what are all the types of geometrical constraints you know?
Idea, sir.
No idea. Okay. Divya, you?
No idea, sir.
Okay. Ready? Do you know anyone?
Concentricity.
Yeah, concentricity.
Parallel.
So those are all the geometrical constraints. Perpendicular, parallel, concentricity, tangency, coincident, coincide, perpendicular. Mm-hmm. Okay. So those are all called as the geometrical constraints here. Okay. So now, first of all, we'll see how to make a sketch dimensionally constrained. To assign the dimension, so what you have to use is you have to use a thing called constraint here. Can you notice here?
Constraint.
So just select the constraint. So what I'll do is I'll just select the center point and this line. See, some distance has been coming up. So if you want to change it, just give a double click on this and I'll assign it as some 100 mm. Okay, so now it has moved. Now the thing is, it is 100% fixed horizontally. You can't move it horizontally. Okay. So now at the same time, what I'll do is I'll make it fix vertically as well. So I'll just give a double click and I'll assign the distance as 100. Now the sketch is constrained or not? Constrained.
Limited.
Sorry? I couldn't hear you.
Sir.
Yeah. Now just tell me, is the sketch constrained or not? See, to check whether the sketch is constrained or not, so what you have to do is, can you see the symbol here? Traffic signal kind of symbol. So red, yellow, and green. So this is called as sketch solving status. Once you click on this, so it is saying it as under constrained. Okay. So in CATIA, so there are three types of constraint. So under constraint, over constraint, and ISO constraint. So every time your sketch should be in a stage of ISO constraint. Okay. So now it is in under constraint. So why it is showing under constraint means, as you can see, I have fixed it vertically and horizontally, but the circumference of the circle is still moving. Okay. So whether you have to assign the radius or dimensions to it, for example, I'll select this constraint. I'll select this and I'll just give a double click. If you want radius, you just go here with radius. And if you want to keep it with diameter, keep it with diameter. I'll assign the thing as some like 70. Okay. Now, if you just click and check here, so it will say it is ISO constrained. Okay. So what is the stage of over constraint? See, I have already given the vertical distance as 100 mm. So now if I try to increase or decrease the dimension, for example, see, now itself it is overdefined. So it is over constrained already. Again, if I just give it double click and if I try to change it at some 110 mm, I'll try to give. So it will be over constrained. Okay. So that means whether it should stick on a single dimension. A sketch could not carry two dimensions at a time. Okay. So it should be given only with a single dimensions. Got my point?
Okay. Yes, sir.
So now if you have a pen and paper, just go ahead and write down this thing. So this is called as, can you notice on the screen? So these are all called as the geometrical constraints. So just take down each and everything and you just tell me one by one, I'll explain you how it is given. So how distance, length, angle, radius, diameter, semi-major, semi-minor, symmetric, endpoint, each and everything I'll show you. Okay. So are you guys taking it down?
Yes, sir.
Make it fast. Okay. Or else you can just have a screenshot of it and you can tell me if you're watching it in a phone or if you are using your laptop, you can directly go with that snipping tool. So once it is done, just tell me, I'll explain you how each and everything is.
Yes, sir, done.
Done. Okay. Lekhana Divya, have you took it down?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So now just tell me one by one. So what is the first geometrical constraint we have?
Distance.
So distance is nothing but this is thing what I have given. From here to here, it is called as a distance. At the same time, see, for example, distance is nothing but this one. So from a point to the center axis is nothing but the distance. Okay. So what is the next geometrical constraint?
Length.
So length is given for some lines. Okay. So for example, if I have a line like this, see, if it is moved something like this, so only a coincident symbol will be shown. So no horizontal symbol will be showing beside this. Okay. So if you want to create a line exactly horizontal or vertical, it should be turned to this blue color. Okay. So for vertical, it will be turned blue and for exactly horizontal, it will be turned blue. So length is nothing but, so this is the length what I've given. So just select this constraint, select that line. So it will give you the length. Again, just double click on this dimension. A dialog box will be appearing here. So you can assign the length, whatever you want. Okay. So after length, what is that?
Angle.
So angle is given for this kind of line, for an inclined line. Just select this. Select this one and this horizontal line here. So you can assign the angle. Even if you want to assign from here to here, you can give, or just move the cursor between these two and you can assign the angle. Just give a double click upon this and assign the angle whatever you want to. Okay. So what is the next thing?
Radius or diameter.
So radius or diameter we have already given here. You just need to give a double click on this. If you want to give the diameter, you can give the diameter. And if you want to give the radius, you can give the radius from here. Okay. So what is the next thing?
semi-major axis.
Semi-major axis and semi-minor axis. So those two axes are given for an ellipse. For example, see, so I'll just select this. So you can notice if I give as a semi-major axis, so the axis will be taken from here to here. See, this is called as the semi-major axis. At the same time, if I just select semi-minor axis, the thing will be given from here to here. Okay, got it? So what is the next thing?
Symmetric.
Symmetric is a quite tricky thing. I'll explain you at the last. Okay, so what is next?
Midpoint.
Midpoint,
sir.
Midpoint, okay. So say midpoint is used, for example, I have a line like this and I have assigned the distance for this thing as some 300 mm. So, and I have another line like this. So to assign this, see, this is very much important. So to assign those kind of geometrical constraints, so what you have to do is you have to select constraint first. So I have selected the constraint. So what I want is I want this point of the line. So see, only the point is being highlighted here. I want to select this point to be take some relation between this line. Just select these two and the dimension is coming, right?
Okay.
And the dimension is moving with your cursor. So when the dimension is moving with your cursor, at that time, give a right click here. So once you give a right click, so these are all the possible constraints, what are all you can give. So you can make it reference swap location. So don't worry about these two things. It will come every time. So the possible geometrical relations, what you can give between this point and this line is midpoint and coincidence. So you want midpoint, just select midpoint. And you can notice that line has been came and fixed here. And if you want to check the dimensions, just select here to here. So sorry. From this particular endpoint to this particular endpoint, it is exactly at the midpoint, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So what is the next geometrical constraint we have?
Equidistance point.
Equidistance point we have learned in our yesterday's point section, right? So that is called as equidistance point.
Yes, sir.
You can directly use it from here. So what is the next geometrical constraint?
Fixed point.
Sorry?
Fixed point.
Fixer. So
yes.
Fix is the thing used when you are doing some of the conceptual sketches. Okay. For conceptual sketches is nothing but without dimensions or without any geometrical constraint, if you are doing something. So those kind of sketches are called as imaginary or conceptual sketches. For example, this circle. I want a circle here and it should be constrained here. Means, so what we'll do is I'll select this constraint. I'll select this circle. I'll give a right click and I'll say fix here. So without any dimension, so that thing will be directly converted to iso constraint. Okay. Okay. So what is the next geometrical constraint we have?
Coincidence.
Okay. Coincidence is used between two points. For example, I'll just select this constraint here. I want this point and this point to be coincided. After, see, when the dimension is coming and it is moving along your cursor, just give a right click there and use it as coincidence. Okay, see, it has been fixed now. So it is fixed to that particular center. Okay, so what is the next thing we have?
Tangency.
Okay, tangency. For example, tangency is given only between a circle and a line. So I'll just select this constraint. Select this line and select this circle, give a right click and make it as tangency. Okay. So what is next?
Parallelism.
So parallelism is given between two lines. Okay. So for example, are these two lines are parallel to each other?
No, sir.
So just select these two lines, give a right click, make them as parallelism. See, it has been parallel and this is the parallel symbol here. Okay. So what is next? Maybe perpendicular, I guess.
It's a perpendicular.
So just select these two lines, give a right click to them and make them perpendicular. So they'll be exactly perpendicular and this is nothing but the perpendicular symbol what we say. So it's 90 degree symbol. Okay. So any other?
Horizontal and vertical.
So horizontal and vertical, it is used, for example, say I have created a line and it is not exactly horizontal. It is something tilted like this. And if you want to make it horizontal, just select constraint, select this line, give a right click and make it horizontal. So at the same time, you have vertical, I guess. So if it is tilted like this, select this line, give a right click, make it as vertical. Okay. That much only, right?
Yes, sir.
So we left with symmetric. So I have to complete this symmetric, right? So
yes,
symmetric is the most important geometrical constraint which you use. By using the symmetric, almost 80% of your sketches get constrained. Okay, so how to use symmetric and what is symmetric is nothing but say, now tell me, is this line equally divided with this vertical line?
No.
If you want to make this equally divided with this line, so what you have to do is just select this constraint, select this endpoint and this endpoint. Okay. So once you select these two endpoints, give a right click and you have allosymmetric line. So select this allosymmetric line and just select the center line. So it will be equally divided. Okay.
Okay, sir.
Okay. Any doubts?
No.
Okay. So the next kind, how you can make it symmetric is, for example, this rectangle. So it is not equally divided with these two lines. So what you can do is, so now I can select these two entities now. So these two vertical lines, right click, allosymmetric with this vertical line. So at the same time, these two horizontal lines should be equally divided with this horizontal line. Okay. So now you can notice it is equally divided. Okay. Any issues?
No, sir.
Okay. Should I go with an sketch example right away?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So did you saw that video what we have uploaded in YouTube? Did you go
yes,
with
sir.
That?
Yes, sir.
Okay. On this profile as well as this operations. Okay. So now I'll be just sharing my full screen. I don't know where I've kept it. So maybe a fixed profile print. So don't worry, I'll just share you these things. Okay. I'll share you in that group. After some time, I'll just directly share you the whole workbook, what we used to give in our academics. Okay. I don't want the sketches. Okay. Okay. So can you see the sketch here? The sketch 11, it is showing actually, it is sketch 1 actually. Okay.
Okay, sir.
Okay. Can you notice the sketch? So this sketch exactly right here. Okay. The sketch 11. So now before starting any sketch, the major important thing is, so where should you start the sketch? For example, in this case, so where should you start the sketch?
So dimensions, I mean, circle, sir.
From this circle, right? Just because
yes, sir.
From this center, each and everything is connected. So I'll just start it directly with the, I'll take two circles, one of dia 40 and one of dia 62 here. So I'll just double click on this. I'll just take two circles, one with diameter of 62 mm and one with the diameter of 40. Okay, so once it is done, so now you can notice, so I have six holes, right? So 1, 2, 3. So here itself he has given six holes of dia 8. Okay. So what I'll do is I'll just go with, so I'll take one circle here. So now the major important thing is, see, now the circle is being created on that circumference of the circle. If I try to move it, you can notice two things are being highlighted, that horizontal line as well as the circle. That means I'm exactly at the coincidence point of that thing. So now I'll just click it here. I'll just create the circle and I'll assign the distance as dia 6. Okay, 6 holes of dia 8, right? Sorry. So now you can notice there is an outer covering to it. So we have an outer covering to it. So this is actually radius 8. The dimension is missing here. The copy what I have, I'll send you. You have every details in that. So this is nothing but the radius 8. So that is called as R8. So now I'll just go with a circle like this. I'll create it here. I'll give the dimension to this as radius 8. Okay. So now you can notice that radius has been trimmed here. See, it is not a full circle. It's a semicircle up to here. So now what I'll do is I'll just trim it off. So I'll just go with this trimming tool. So that is I'll use this trim. So quick trim I'll use. I'll just delete this things. Okay. Any doubts till now?
No, sir.
Okay. So now tell me, like this thing, how many we have? We have six, right? So, what is the what is the total angle of a circle? 360 degrees. Someone is, I'll feel, I'm feeling like someone is speaking from far away. Who's that? I heard
360 degrees.
Oh, okay, great. So now, if I divide this 360 by 6, what is the distance angle between these two? I have a total angle of 360. So now this entities are 6. If I divide 360 by 6, I'll get 60 degrees between each, right?
Yes, sir.
60, 60, 60, 60, 60. So now I have two options. So the first option is I can take a line like this. I'll place it here. And I can give the angle from here to here as how much? 60 degrees. And again, I have to draw the same thing. Or else the another option what I have is, I'll just double click on this. I'll give it to 30 degrees. And if I mirror this upon this 30 degree line, it will be coming to directly 60, right?
Okay, yes, sir.
Got my point, right? What I'm trying to explain you. Any doubts?
No, sir.
Okay. And the major important things for these kind of mirroring lines, don't use this thick line. Always use this axis lines. Okay. Okay. Now what I'll do is I'll just select these four things. I'll mirror upon directly this, just because from here to here, it will be 100% 30 degree. From here to here, it will be 30 to total 60. And again, this one 60. Now again, I'll just select these four entities. I'll mirror upon this horizontal line. So it has done, right? So yes, now I'll just double click on this trim. I'll just try to remove each and everything from here, just because these lines are not visible there. See, I guess I left with 10 minutes. If this meeting ends, you just directly join to the same link, okay? I'll just try to complete it within 10 minutes so that you all have a full complete recording of this session. Okay. So once it is done, so now if you can notice the same sketch here. Okay. So I have a circle of 65 from here and from the axis, and we have three circles with dia 20. Okay. So now what I'll do is I'll just try to create a circle like this here. And I'll assign the distance from here to here as 65 what he has given. So at the same time, the circle has been mirrored upon this line, and the distance between these two circles has given as 110. Okay. So it has been given it as 110. Now the thing is, why it is not?
Sir, will it be symmetric, sir?
Yeah, if you mirror, it will be automatically symmetric. Okay. So now the thing is, So it is 110. So once you mirror something, so it will automatically become symmetric also. Okay. So now he has given the diameter for this circles as 20. Now there is a third circle here. See, the third circle is on the arc from here to here, exactly at the meeting point of this thing. So I need to create an arc there. So to create an arc, what I'll do is I'll just switch on this, what we say, that sketch tools. So I'll just switch it on. Now I'll go with this arc here. So the center point arc, I'll select this as my starting point, the start point and the end point of the arc. See, I got an arc, the two, it is a dotted arc. I'll just switch it off now. Again, I'll go with the circle. I'll select this as my midpoint. And again, I'll assign the dimensions to this as 20 mm. Oh, sorry, I guess it took 200, 20 mm. Now you can notice there is a circle upon here. So it is nothing but it is R15. Okay. So again, the dimension is missing here. So it is R15. So I have two circles of R15 here. So I'll just create them over here. So that is nothing but it will be having the diameter of 30, right? So or else you can go with the R15 itself. So I'll just mirror this guy upon this line. Now there is an arc touching to these two guys. So to do that, what I'll do is I'll just directly go with this center point arc. I'll just select this as my exact center point. Okay, you can notice it is showing it as 0, 0. So now just try to create an arc like this. Now what I'll do is I'll just make it tangent to it. So I'll make this one and this one as tangency. I'll make this one and this one as tangency. Okay. So once it is done, I'll just remove these two things. So I don't want this. So now the left out part is this much. Okay. It is easy. So a straight line and a curve here. Okay. So to do that, what I'll do is I'll just create a random line like this. Okay. See, while creating this kind of line, just don't give this kind of relations. Now, see, it is taking a relation with the middle circle. Okay. So don't try to let it be free. See, now it is free. It is not being touched or it is not being taking any relations like this. So let it be free. So once it is done, what I'll do is I'll just make this guy and this line as tangency and I'll just pull it out. I'll just pull this line up to like this and I'll give a fillet of R18, I guess he has given. See, a fillet of R18 here. So just go with this fillets. See, while giving fillet in this kind of thing, see, if you try to assign the fillet here, see, this kind of trimming has been done, right? So it is being trimmed automatically. To avoid those things, what you have to do is once you select this corner trim, a small box will be appearing here. So here, what you have to select is you have to go with no trim. Okay. So just click on this no trim, select this one and this one and assign the radius, double click and assign the radius as 18. Now, what you can do is you just trim this one as well as this one. Now just press the control button, select these two guys, same mirror upon this particular line and it is being done. So just double click and you don't have these things. I'll just remove this and you can notice your sketch has been done and the sketch is ISO constrained. Okay. See, did I took it fast?